Hello everybody. See here, I have already told you about special types of matrices, but only I have told you the properties of symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. I have not told you about the properties of orthogonal matrix. So, what is the definition of orthogonal matrix?
If A is a square matrix, then A is equal to orthogonal. If A to A transpose is equal to A transpose into A is equal to I. I is the unit matrix. If A into A transpose is equal to A transpose into A is equal to I. So see the properties. In the entrance examinations, remember mindfully, there will be four properties from different matrices, different types of matrices, and you have to indicate which property is correct or which property is wrong. So you have to know all the properties. Clear? See here. I am doing the proof. Bit 1. See here. If A is orthogonal, that means given A is orthogonal, that means A into A transpose. Your A transpose into A is equal to I. Then A transpose is also orthogonal. It is clear. So simply I am writing this one as first one. A transpose into A, your A into A transpose is equal to I. Clear? In place of A, I have written A transpose. In place of A, I have written A transpose. So this one, A transpose or transpose, it will become A. That means, see here, I can write this one. A transpose, transpose, your A into A transpose of transpose into A transpose is equal to I. Compare these two. In place of A, I have written A transpose. A transpose of transpose, this one. Clear? So comparing these two, in place of A, I have written A transpose. That means if A is orthogonal, then A transpose is also orthogonal. Clear? Or you may do like this. Take the transpose on both the sides. Simply take the transpose on both the sides. It will become A into A transpose, whole transpose. Is equal to A transpose into A whole transpose is equal to I transpose. So it will become reversal law. AB whole transpose is B transpose into A transpose, not A transpose into B transpose. So it will become A transpose into A transpose is equal to, this is A transpose reversal law, A transpose is equal to I, because the transpose of unit matrix is I. So comparing these two, we have got, simply I have written A transpose in place of A. A transpose in place of A. So therefore A transpose is orthogonal. Clear? Now come to the second part. Second point, second property, that is. What is the second property? A and B are orthogonal. That means A into A transpose is equal to B into B. A transpose into A is equal to I. And B into B transpose is equal to B transpose into B is equal to I. These are the given conditions. And you have to prove AB and B are orthogonal. See here, A is orthogonal. That means A into A transpose. A is orthogonal. The given matrix is A. So A multiplied with its transpose should be unit matrix. The given matrix into the transpose of the given matrix should be 1. Here the given matrix is AB, because we have to prove AB is orthogonal. Clear? So now AB into AB transpose. Let us see what will be the answer. AB. What is the transpose of this one? Reversal law. B transpose into A transpose. Clear? Then apply the associative property into A transpose. Clear? Then again associative A into B, B transpose into A transpose. But B into B transpose is I. So A into I into A transpose. and A into I is A. So A into A transpose. And A into A transpose is I. So your I. Clear? So that means I is orthogonal. Similarly, you can prove DA is orthogonal. Clear? Now, the third point. Third point is given. A is orthogonal. A is orthogonal. Now, you have to prove A inverse is orthogonal. So how to prove? Who can tell me? Given A is orthogonal, that means A into A transpose into A transpose into A is equal to I. And you have to prove A inverse is orthogonal. So take the inverse on both the sides. A into A inverse, A transpose whole inverse, your A transpose into A whole inverse is equal to I. Clear? And already it is known to you, AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. This is also reversal. The inverse of AB is your B inverse into A inverse. So tell me, A transpose whole inverse into A inverse is equal to A inverse into A transpose whole inverse is equal to I. So it will become this part, A inverse whole transpose, because there is a property. I'll prove it in the inverse into A inverse is equal to A inverse. Sorry, this one is minus 1. A inverse to the power transpose is equal to I. So see here, compare this equation with this equation. In place of A, I have written A inverse. A inverse into A inverse transpose. A inverse transpose into A inverse is equal to I. That means A inverse is orthogonal. Clear? So I have already proved these three properties. So you have to remember the three properties. Clear? So please note down this one. I am going to tell you another property. Okay?